We'll go back to Boston Garden in just a moment, but first let's show you what happened to the Alamo Dome tonight when the water system was kicked off by the fireworks before the Warriors and San Antonio Spurs game. This delayed the start of the game as people got wiped out, brought the umbrellas out, and retreated from their seats at the Alamo Dome. They are going to get that game underway in moments. Back to Boston Garden after these words.
Lead is down to 7. Ewing got the step and was rejected by Ryder. What a play by Ryder.
Open. Pass, baby. 5-5, baby. You know, two guys don't miss. We're going to play defense. We're going to work hard and make a free throw.
Jackson State. About 3. Duke has one last chance to tie. If
Hunter
misses.
Jackson, what's happening? Oh, that lane violation. Hill shoots a 3. Gets fouled. Gets 3 free throws. Tied up.
Wait a minute. Hunter calls timeout. Resume play.
Hill's so confident, he steps on left hand. He steps on left hand.
But his ice right water foot was on the line, so he has to shoot it over. No!
Hardaway taking it inside again. He's missing the mark. O'Keefe will need 35-33. Awesome. Hornets in the lead by 12. That time O'Neal got in behind everybody. Glad. Hardaway to O'Neal. O'Neal with 20. Yep, right at the bridge of the nose. Here comes Anderson to O'Neal for the dunk. A sweet combination. The block and then the three. O'Neal.
Oh my goodness. Well, Barry, be careful.
With Mourning, Parrish, and Johnson in the game at the same time. Influenced by Mourning, stuck back by O'Neal. Alley-oop to O'Neal, he gets behind everybody, and O'Neal puts Orlando in the lead with his 34th point of the night. Magic leading by two here in the fourth. Hardaway, blocked by Parrish, but it's O'Neal, and nobody caught the trailer. It's only the second team foul on the Hornets. They have two to give before the penalty. Here's O'Neal.
Kneel.
You must kneel in front of that.
Oh my goodness.
117-109.
Wow, that's amazing.
Hornets calling for the 24-second violation. It wasn't whistled. Here comes Shaw inside. Doesn't get it. O'Neal grabbed it home. 40 points for Shaquille O'Neal. And Charlotte wants a timeout. 21.9 seconds left. And Orlando leads it 119-117. Johnson on the free throw line. 48.2 seconds. The shot. Good. Headed back in. Maybe that's the World Cup soccer influence.
Well, I mean, he was in the world basketball games.
Ooh, gets the second. Notice the evolution of his foul shot. Gone is that hesitation that was there in his rookie season. Tree Rollins trying to check into the ball game, but they won't be allowed. 69 points now, and they've hit the 70 mark. Hornets and Cavs, Tuesday night at 7:30. Hope you'll join us right here. Johnson brings the Hornets to within one.
No offense there.
Nope. Larry drives it up.
Seconds remaining. Pat Riley says no timeout. Go for it. Starks. We're down to five. Ewing for the win. Yes! Still 2:14 remaining. Patrick Ewing with the baseline jump shot.
Now Mashburn picked up by Crisco. Purdue comes over to help out. Jason Kidd. Mashburn for three. He can hit that by five. Mashburn for three again. Just two. Good interior feed. Popeye Jonesburg. Mashburn in on Purdue. Mashburn posting up Pippen. Nicely done.
Bills coming off again.
Mashburn muscles in possession of the second half. Mashburn, good look from Popeye. Mashburn in close. Scored in a
in on the block. Mashburn. He's been finishing everything.
Kid to Jackson with the right hand. Mashburn on the block. Yes, this is easy for Mashburn. On Mashburn on the block. Now they get Mashburn out of the floor. For three. Wow. Mavs won last night at Philadelphia. Mashburn to the hole. Head down the stretch here in this ball game. 10 to go on the shot clock for Mashburn. Tough.
One. Van Exel lobs into Jones. Slam dunk. Coming with Sabalas. Lob under for Sabalas. Slam dunk. Boy, boring and good plays. You're at the right store. Here's a dribble drive by Van Exel. Look at that little alley-oop. Baldwin, Van Exel, no look pass. He gets it down the floor from Peeler. I called it rumble. He's made the last 6 points for the Lakers. Dribble drive Van Exel. Van Exel underneath the basket gives it off and kind of goes over to Van Exel for three. Didn't want the shot. Looks, gives it to, oh, nice pass under to Jones. Van Exel gets the screen, stop, shoot the high arc, shot and hits it. All in this quarter. All in this quarter by Fox. He's made 5 out of 6 field goals. Van Exel down the middle, beats Wesley. Scoop shot, good. Van Exel gets the screen by Sabalas. Van Exel down the middle, high arch. Oh, what a shot! Okay, stop, didn't shoot it. Van Exel didn't. 5 in the clock, down the middle. Van Exel throws it up and in. Van Exel will come behind it. Or he should. Ball is into Van Exel.
He fires. It'll count if it goes. It went! It went! It went!
That's only right.
A miracle at Boston Garden. A three-pointer. When he started the shot, I believe his back was to the basket,
yeah.
Stu.
He did a turn in the air, Chick. And I mean to tell you, he got a lot of height on that ball as well. But the end result was, Nick said, this will teach you to give the game or give the possession to them. As Nick just turns, fires, and it goes. Time runs.
Missing the mark. O'Keefe O'Neal with the slam. He's got seven now. 45-33. Points in the lead by 12. That time O'Neal got in behind everybody. Hardaway to O'Neal. Neal with 20. Hit right at the bridge of the nose. Here comes Anderson to O'Neal for the dunk. A sweet combination. The block and then the three. O'Neal.
Oh my goodness. Barry, be careful.
With Mourning, Parrish, and Johnson in the game at the same time. Influenced by Mourning, stuck back by O'Neal. Alley-oop to O'Neal, he gets behind everybody, and O'Neal puts Orlando in the lead with his 34th point of the night. Magic leading by two here in the fourth. Hardaway, blocked by Parrish, but it's O'Neal, and nobody caught the trailer. It's only the second team foul on the Hornets. They have two to give before the penalty. Here's O'Neal. You must kneel in front of that.
My goodness.
117-109.
Wow, that's amazing.
Hornets calling for the 24-second violation. It wasn't whistled. Here comes Shaw inside. Doesn't get it. O'Neal rammed it home. 40 points for Shaquille O'Neal. And Charlotte wants a timeout. 21.9 seconds left. And Orlando leads it 119-117.
Look at the run by Payton. Gary Payton is off early. Gary Payton is 2 for 2 as he rises over Hot Rod Williams. Payton just whirls by Mark Price hard to the bucket.
Payton had yet to miss a field goal, and his hot streak continued.
Payton with a roll. Gary Payton tonight absolutely on fire. He's now 6 for 6 from the floor. Payton's going to start the run. Look at the ball movement. Payton 10 for 10. Starts that Seattle run again. Payton to the hole. Yep.
Then I realized I had 12 in a row, and I was like, man, I did that.
Payton's going to be 13 for 13. Payton, how about 14 for 14? That is a team record for the Seattle Sonics.
You know what? I told them that you're one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen, and that they should show you on TV today. What is your name?
Patty.
Patty? I am Charles. Nice to meet you. Hey, are you married?
No, I'm not.
You not? Why aren't you married? Well, I tell you what, you don't have to wonder anymore. Somebody got something to say to you.
Patty, I want to know if you'll marry me. Want you to look.
Well, everybody in the world wants to know.
Of course I
am. All right.
And there they are watching with a little TV. She had to think about it a minute, you know, before she said okay. And I think Charles promised to perform the ceremony.
Trying to get it over Montrose. That's going to be good. And you got Campbell out in front here. You got to get the ball.
He's going
to
be setting
one of your shooters. And Van Exel will come behind it. Or he should. Ball is into Van Exel. He fires. It'll count if it goes. It went! It went! It went!
That's only right.
A miracle at Boston Garden. A three-pointer. When he started the shot, I believe his back was to the basket,
yeah.
Stu.
He did a turn in the air.
Steps through. Shaw tried to block it, made him change it. They've had it again. Now the Magic have a break. Here's Hardaway. Oh, on Ewing. Oh, baby. He was posterized.
drive. Oh, Jason! Kid.
Oh,
look at
what
that
a pass to Smith.
Jason Kidd storms into the front court. Oh, splits the move. Double team and lays it in. Kidd off the move. Oh, what a shot by Kidd. Jason Kidd. Backdoor play to Harris.
Double team feeds it out to Hurley. Ball knocked loose. Breakaway Jason Kidd. It's an 8-point Dallas run.
Kidd spins away from Bogues. And it's easy once you beat him.
Oh, nice pass.
Oh, the dunk.
Hey, on the dribble to the top of the circle. Quickness to the left hand. That got him inside.
Kidd will shoot up a three. He got it! Kidd has tied the game.
See what they're talking about. Jason Kidd came in here averaging 7.5 assists a game.
Did you see him just handling the ball and reading the floor? Never looked down as he was handling that ball.
So you're looking at Stefano Rusconi, who is the first Italian citizen to play in the NBA. And he's recently come under the tutelage of Professor Barkley.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, since we got the first Italian to play in the NBA, I thought it would be in our best interest to teach him some American words. You ready, Stefano?
Ready. First lesson.
First lesson.
Good.
Come on over to my office. Homie.
Homie.
Homie means friend.
Homie means friend.
Yeah, I'm your homie. Yeah. Homie.
Here's Hardaway. Oh, my dear. Oh, baby. He was posterized here in the arena. One pass too many. Deflected Anderson. 2-on-1 break. He's got Shaq. He'll run the floor. The finger on you. Oh, my goodness. 7-1. 3-0-3 down the heart of the floor. O'Neal in traffic, a beauty. Joined by Kevin Johnson, the fine point guard for the Suns. You've been injured now with an injured groin. This is the fifth straight game you've missed. When will you be back, Kevin?
I'll tell you what, I'll be back at the first of the year. So hopefully 96 will be my year, injury free.
Kevin, you missed 35 games last year, 88 games over the past three seasons. Do you begin to wonder if you'll ever be healthy again?
I just quit adding them up. I just have to say my prayers and hopefully that 96 and 97 I'll be healthy.
Do you feel as though this team will be able to rebound from their poor start?
I really think so. We get Danny Manning, myself back. I think we're really coming together.
Will steps out, gets it back.
Change the play, Tommy. What an exciting electric finish. 3.3. Still a lot of time. Pip with a crusher. We'll take another look at it. Boom. Up high on that Todd Day foul. Pip with a free throw here. We're tied at 86. Alton Lister to come back in the game.
Scotty steps off the free throw line. Look at this. Boom.
Oh.
Now a big free throw, John. 3.3 seconds left.
There it is.
They get it in. Baker's going to have to throw. Look out. Short. And the Bulls get the win.
Bulls win this one, brother.
Hey, Mikey. We like it.
Not a huge surprise, but clearly one of the great comebacks since Burt Reynolds' hairline. It came in a two-word statement, which is now just begging to have a Nike campaign built around it. Quote, unquote, I'm back. That's all Jordan said on Saturday. That was really all Jordan needed to say as his 17-month retirement came to an end. He will be back on Sunday when the Bulls play the Pacers, and probably not so coincidentally, the game is on national TV. The Bulls arrived in Indianapolis on Saturday night, and while Michael Jordan was not on the team charter, he will be there by game time, and that makes Phil Jackson happy.
We're all very happy about this. We think it's going to be great for our basketball club. We hope expectations, which are going to be high, aren't overreaching for what we have as a basketball club. We're just glad he's getting back on the court.
I'm happy that he's back. I think he's going to add a lot to the NBA, especially in the playoffs. I think he's back because he was missing competition, and he's ready to go again. But I don't think, in my mind, I don't favor them to win it.
We feel we have the best record in the world, and we're going to try to keep going and get to the finals. You know, however they handle their team, that's their own business. Welcome him back, but we don't care or concern ourselves with them.
It's going to make things very interesting. There's not much more you can say about it.
What number, by the way, is Michael going to wear? Do we know?
Well, I assume it's 23, but people are speculating he might wear his baseball number 45.
Jordan returns to the NBA on NBC at noon Eastern.
Kako's a good team. I think obviously it's going to be very difficult for them to win three series in a row. So obviously he makes your team a lot better. But I think for them to get through three rounds on the road is going to be very difficult.
Jordan is it's unbelievable. And, you know, him being back on the floor is going to make that team pretty solid now.
It's good for our league, you know. And I'm happy that he made the right decision. I think this is the right decision for him.
I wish they'd heard himself a baseball strike. But, you know, it's going to make it a lot tougher for teams like us, Indiana, Cleveland. You have to put Chicago right back up there as a contender for the championship now.
I look at it, if we play, if I see them this year, that means I'm in the finals. I like my chances, you know. I think we all like to see them play against us this year. Every guy in this locker room is rooting for that, cheering for that.
Michael.
You mean the baseball player?
I think it, you know, it's good he's back.
Tired means you can do anything you want from this day on. So if I desire to come back and play again, maybe that's what I want to do. Maybe that's the challenge that I may need someday down the road.
And that day has arrived. Michael Jordan warming up at Market Square Arena more than 3 hours before today's scheduled tip-off. 21 months have passed since Michael Jordan last played competitive basketball. For 21 months, the NBA was without its supreme artist. There may be many interesting peripheral aspects to both his departure and return, but at the heart of it is simply this: the best in the world is back. And in a sports world darkened by constant talk of money, strikes, and lockouts, here's a shining reminder of why we're drawn to sports in the first place. The drama, the anticipation, the sheer beauty of the moment. Today, an artist returns to his true canvas, the hardboard courts of the NBA.
He doesn't want to simply be effective or even be an all-star. He wants to be the best again. He wants to dominate. Can he? And if he can, are the Bulls a championship contender?
The atmosphere in Market Square was electric.
We ran out onto the floor, and anxiety, it felt like the finals.
Boy, oh boy, listen to the reaction here at Market Square Arena as Michael took the court.
It was an emotional moment. There he was back.
The last Chicago.
6'6 from North Carolina, number 45, Michael Jordan.
Appearance in an NBA game, Michael Jordan has returned and he's wearing number 45.
I didn't want to go to 23 because I knew my father wasn't there to watch me, and I felt it was a new beginning.
A player to wear number 45, Ed Neely. Michael a little bit nervous trying to live up to Ed Neely. He put his pants on backwards. He struggled early trying to shake off the rust, the 18-month layoff, and it showed. Michael, outside, inside, couldn't get it to go. Then the patented drive. Michael, Rick Smits gets a piece of it. Michael, 0 for 6 from the floor. Indiana, ready to.
His first field goal, and there it is.
I was thinking possible drive here, gave him the jumper, and Michael finally nails one.
Play, Reggie Miller, the pull-up for three that touches nothing but the bottom of the net. Indiana by 10 at the break. Then the old Jordan.
Promise, we say he's back, but he's really not back at 100% but having an outstanding day. Michael Jordan
would finally emerge. MJ the steal from Rick Smits and takes it the distance. And he wanted to throw this one down in the worst way. Mark Jackson got out of the way. Pacers on the run. Mark Jackson.
Ready to jump over him if he had it. As we said, starting this third quarter, Marv, that Michael realizes things are just not very smooth at the offensive end.
MJ on the drive, can't connect. Jordan 7 of 28 from the floor. And Reggie playing the two-man game. The Pacers would lead by as many as 18. Even in slow motion, nobody could block Mark Jackson's shot. More problems for Jordan.
Shot clock at 8. Jordan for Kukoc. Yes. Seconds. Now they double up. Here's Jordan slicing his way, setting up. Yes. Jordan going glass to recapture the ball. Michael Jordan. Yes.
However, the Bulls would come back thanks to Scottie Pippen. 19 seconds to go. We're tied at 92. Pacers' last chance, and they look to Reggie Miller. Jordan and the Bulls have fouled a give. and he gave it. And we go into overtime. In overtime, Jordan goes inside, using the height advantage over Byron Scott. Jordan hobbling, still feeling the effects of the collision with Miller. The Pacers would get the last word. Byron Scott, 2 of the 17. Not quite a Disney ending for Michael Jordan.
19 points, 6 rebounds, 6 assists.
You know, I'm back playing a game that I truly love. When you look back at all the great players that play the game and what they tried to pass on is a legacy of being able to play this game. For the young guys are not taking care of their responsibilities in terms of maintaining that love for the game. I just think you should respect the game and certainly not take advantage of it. You know, when you don't do that, the integrity of the game is at stake.
And the other guard, 6'6", from North Carolina, number 45, Michael Jordan. Early going, first quarter. 2-0 Celtics. Michael against Sherman Douglas.
Oh! Uh-oh, get a three.
Jordan for three.
Uh-oh. He's going to get caught for an illegal defense if they don't get back to him.
Jordan up and firing, and he hits again.
Michael saw BJ breaking over his shoulder.
Michael backing Miner, the fadeaway. Antoine Carr and Cliff Levingston playing behind those two players at Wichita State. Here's Michael.
Three, but it was a long deuce.
Jordan.
One hand pivot.
He had six at Indiana. Jordan. Oh. Jordan. Whoa! Weddington.
Who's he got in this game? Michael.
Hip hop. Jordan for the jam. Yes. Jordan.
Strong enough.
Dee Brown slapping away at it.
Shut up. Well, we know one guy that can get it up.
Jordan. With two to go on the short. Michael gets a screen from Longley. Now.
Beautiful play by Jordan. Longley rolling through. He's got 11 points, and he'll take a timeout.
Less than 2 years, you're back. Why now? Why jump back into a fishbowl that's even bigger than the one you left?
Well, I mean, either way, my life has been a fishbowl no matter what. You know, on the court, off the court, that's just something that I've kind of created for myself and certainly of my family. But one thing I kind of totally forgot, you know, once I retired 18 months ago was my love for the game of basketball. As much as I tried to stay away from the game, I mean, the more times that I played, the more times that my appetite got wet.
You're coming home tonight, but this arena isn't really home. I mean, your home is across the street.
Well, the way that I see it is it's the neighborhood. It's the same neighborhood, but it's a different house.
How long are you here for?
Well, I mean, I got to finish out my contract, and, you know, that's a couple years, I think. And from that point on, I mean, I got to evaluate what my interests are at that particular time. And I don't want to look so far in the future that, you know, I'm pressed to live out a certain schedule. My life has always been, and my motto has always been to live it day by day, you know, and not try to think so far in advance that you kind of forget about the present. You know, I want to live for the present at this particular time, and the present is that I'm playing for the Bulls now, and I look forward to finishing out my contract. Now, what happens from that point on, you know, certainly is whatever I feel at that moment.
Were there any stipulations that Scotty and Phil Jackson and you would be together through the duration?
It was a question, certainly. You know, I wanted to know what the status of these gentlemen were. I mean, I wasn't demanding not one thing. I've never demanded since I've been here, and I wasn't going to start at that particular time. Even so, you know, I could have easily, but I've never operated from that angle, you know. And, yeah, I asked about Phil. I asked about BJ. I asked about Pippen, Tony, you know, just to see where I stood, you know. And that had a lot to do with my decision-making. But, you know, I didn't demand these guys to get new contracts or you know, whatever, you know, what all the speculations were. But, you know, in terms of myself, I didn't ask for no extra money. I knew I couldn't because of the moratorium, and I came back under my own contract.
Do you think you can win a fourth title as it's constituted?
Certainly. I wouldn't be here if I didn't.
Michael is better than most at 3-on-2. And the trailer, hello!
Mike may have to go solo. He can. He did.
Dang it. And he likes that attitude.
Jordan falling away. Jordan gets the pick from Purdue. Kukoc gives it up to Jordan, who is now taking control. Having trouble initiating the triple post offense. Odlin trying to stay with Michael.
Oh,
boy, that is tough, isn't it?
Good defender. Oh, Michael.
Hawks have hit the wall offensively. And the foul. Jordan for the win.
Regular day at the office, back at work, Michael Jordan back in rhythm.
And the reality is, single coverage is there because there are so many others that can beat you to his wings.
Absolutely right. And once again, Bill Jackson and the Bulls say, take us home, Michael. And he does. Run at the Hawks, put him in motion, stops, takes his jumper, hangs, scores it. Regular day at the office, back at work, Michael Jordan back in rhythm.
And the reality is, single coverage is there because there are so many others that can beat you to his wings.
Absolutely right. And once again, Bill Jackson and the Bulls say, take us home, Michael. And he does.
99-98, the Bulls get it done on a masterful 32-point performance from MJ.
I like coming out pretty good. I mean, playing so many minutes, I don't have a choice, you know. But I think Phil's giving me a crash course in terms of getting my minutes back, and so it's coming around pretty good.
Mike, what does your own agenda tonight consist of? What kind of performance would you like to have?
I just like to see us win, you know, and I like to shoot a better percentage and make contributions in all phases of the game. We're still trying to find ourselves, and they're a much better team than we are right now. New York and Orlando are two premier teams in this league, and especially in the East, and I think we get to see what kind of work we need to work on down the stretch to even give this team a challenge somewhere in the future.
Keep rolling. No matter what he does. Oh! Did you get that?
Hey! Don't give Kevin too much pressure. Hey! Get out!
Michael Jordan is returning. He released a press release today that said, quote, I'm back.
At the time that I retired, I didn't have anything to prove. Now I got something to prove.
Hole number 45 is back. Game number 5 of the Michael Jordan reunion tour. Michael just loves to play here at Madison Square Garden. For Michael Jordan, who fires, yes.
I feel that my skills are back to where the game is going to dictate what type of game I'm going to have.
Jordan gets inside, easy hoop.
Once I'm on the basketball court, I'm in my dreamland. You know, this is what I enjoy doing. I love playing the game of basketball.
Here's the post up by Jordan. Off the spin.
Would he have made that look any easier with the giant step?
I'm not always going to come out and score 55 points. I'm not always going to come out in the first quarter to look for my shot.
Jordan off the crowd. Puts the move on, starts, yes.
I shot the ball very well. I felt myself in great rhythm tonight.
55 points by Michael Jordan.
I believe in my skills now that, you know, I can apply it whenever it's necessary.
Jordan sets up Wellington. 3 seconds to go.
The Bulls beat the Knicks.
55 points, but nice assist at the end.
Hey, don't count on me shoot it every time. I can pass.
Okay, back to you, Bob.
Thank you, Craig. 113, 111.
Again, trail by 10. Jordan, no look, Purdue! Oh, beautiful feed from Jordan!
A
Ahmad Rashad here in Chicago at the United Center. Now, everybody knows about Michael Jordan feeling uncomfortable here at the United Center. Well, this morning he told me he had a secret weapon, something that would make him feel more comfortable. And what it was the shoes that he wore his rookie year, also the shoes that he wore when he scored 63 points against the Boston Celtics. There was only one problem with this secret weapon is that he didn't try them on before he left the house. And once he got here, he realized that after 10 years, his foot had grown and the shoes would not fit. The only thing that will fit is in my suitcase on the way out of here, Marv.
Yes, and Matt.
Benjamin DeWalters. In on curve. Blocked by Jordan.
Walters comes down. Steve Kerr just backed out of the way.
The free throw line, 57.
Filing over to help. Jordan able to slip through and hits. Michael Jordan with a reverse. The Chicago Bulls bench enjoying
the middle. Orlando 3 out of 10. Hardaway as Thomas patted the ball. Turner against Dumars. Holloway left hand. A beauty. On the floor, beats Dennis Scott. He'll plant fire for 21 good. Oh, Hunter. Deadly crossover. Hardaway picked his pocket. Now the Magic run out. 4-on-1. Behind the back, Anderson off balance. Gone! Four to shoot. He's double. He'll need to fire it up. The two to shoot. Gone! Shaq hits 30 for the 29th time.
Steve Kerr, he's got that outside stroke.
Hello, Steve Kerr, wide open tray.
Yeah.
Wiley almost got a piece of it again. He's
Kerr,
a good shooter.
4-3 on the feed from Pippen. Kerr from the old NBA range.
Here's Kerr.
Trails 81-73. Kemp. Tied up? No. Foul by Divac. That's four on Vlade Divac.
Sometimes Kemp isn't ready to go right up, and this is one of those times. He caught the ball and then had to gather him.
Put a power surge.
Now, this is what George Karl needed. He needed something to break the momentum. Now, this is really home court advantage. You can't have better timing than this. Now you get a break. The lights are down here at the Tacoma Dome.
Well, there have been some cloudy days in the Seattle area, but this beats them all.
This is not, you know, in terms of playing in a totally dark arena. Players used to play like this when they grew up.
Sure.
You had to sneak in. Couldn't turn the lights on, but now they want all of the lights on, so we've got a break in the action, and Dell Harris is going to try to keep this team focused for this final 4-11.
We got him. We got him. Stay focused, baby. Stay focused.
Oh, some emergency lights have come on upstairs.
Well, the playoffs, we've seen a lot of strange things, but have never been in a playoff.
A storm 81-73. Play has been halted as the main lighting system has failed. Let's check in with Hannah Storm. Hannah.
Well, Greg, the problem is the entire city of Tacoma, the entire grid that we're on right here, has had a power surge. So lights are not only out in this stadium, but everywhere, all over Tacoma. They have to let these lights cool down. They don't have any other lights more available than the ones that you see now. In other words, they have no backup generator, no backup lighting that would be sufficient to play basketball. What they have to do is wait for the main lights here, which have gone out, to cool down. That'll be 5 minutes, maybe as long as 10 minutes, before those can be turned on again and we can resume play here at the Tacoma Dome, Greg.
All right, Anna, Steve, if you would just take your foot off of this plug right here, we'd probably be okay. You know,
6-1 in the elimination games, and Drexler kind of putting us. The next is playoff average here.
MJ hangs
the glass. Big hoop by Michael, 42. Michael Jordan with a sensational basket. You watch white shirts coming at him. He fades, three guys at him, off the glass, boom.
Steve Kerr will come in for the Bulls.
So they don't need, maybe.
Cedric is a maverick. He plays his own game out there, and he'll bounce back. It's not like anybody has control of his movements out on the court. He plays very instinctively, and so Nick nor I can really move him around. He'll find ways. It just wasn't a good game for him.
Rally.
Oh, hang on.
2-point ball game.
And behind their dominant big man, Houston escaped with the first round win.
Pack him up. We're headed. Baby's over. There's Jordan. Yes. You can't believe it.
This is NBA Showtime. Here's your host, Bob Costas.
Fouls called. Actually, that is short of the record for both teams in a playoff game. Miller for three, and he got it. Reggie Miller with a clutch tray, and it's 105-102. And a steal. Miller retreats to the three-point line and hits again.
Reggie Miller has tied the game with 13 seconds remaining.
Reggie Miller made a three, stole the ball, raced behind the three-point line, and hit again.
One of the greatest clutch playoff performers of his generation has apparently done it again.
Teams in a playoff game. Miller for three, and he got it. Reggie Miller with a clutch tray, and it's 105-102. And a steal. Miller retreats to the three-point line and hits again.
Tie game. No need to foul in that situation.
Starks misses. Batted around. Ewing has it. His shot no good. Reggie Miller the rebound and a foul with 7.5 seconds. Only the second time in 16 games here at the Garden in against the New York Knicks. Indiana has reached 100 points. They won the other time. Maybe this will be the magic number for them here as well.
It's like Indiana's win in game one at Orlando last year.
Miller hits two.
No timeouts.
Miller hits two.
No timeouts.
Anthony stumbles and falls. Time runs out. Reggie Miller scoring 8 points in the final 32 seconds.
One of the most remarkable comebacks in all of basketball.
The score. Chicago with the lead with 18 and 1/10 seconds to play.
And Jordan spinning his way against Anderson. Here comes Hardaway. Six and 2/10 seconds to go. Another look as Nick Anderson did it from behind, chasing Jordan, knocked it away, leading to this.
And Penny Hardaway finds Horace Grant.
Anderson trying to steal it. Jordan dribbles around him. Clock is down to 12, and Anderson stole the ball. Hardaway picked it up. Two on one. Penny bounced past the ground. He drops it. 6.2 seconds.
Any thoughts on where they might go?
Well, first of all, you got to get the basketball in, and that's sometimes going to be difficult. You've got to get it in. They'll get it in Van Exel's hands. They could go to a high pick and roll. They could try to go inside to one of the big guys, but I think they'll try to get it in Van Exel's hands, and he has made some big plays for this club all year.
San Antonio had a 6-point lead with 2.5 to go. He's down to 1 with 18.5. Lottie Devots will inbound.
They have a timeout, yet they don't want to use it.
Van Exel, Sabalos, Campbell, Rodman getting...
He's off the ball trying to stop. They got it to Van Exel.
Van Exel guarded by Avery Johnson.
They've got an isolation. They flash Campbell.
Here's Campbell, guarded by Robinson, playing with 5 fouls. Campbell in and out. The ball is tipped, and it's saved. 3 seconds left. Here's Van Exel. This is for the win. He got it! He got it! With 3/10 of a second left. Nick Van Exel, who's 3, tied it up at 88 all, takes the runner and cans the jumper. And the Lakers are on top by 2.
Smith. The cutting Sam Mitchell. He's surrounded by white jerseys. Miller lets it go. Doesn't get the 3. But they'll get another opportunity. He'll try it again. Smith will give him a 3rd try.
Oh,
to Davis.
Man.
No. Jackson. Miller for 3. No. Loose ball. Ewing comes up with it. A 19,000 stand.
4-on-1.
Mason.
Coming to the 10 to shoot, Miller for 3! Smith, the offensive rebound, Reggie from 30 feet, buries it!
Lock.
The tip, Indiana will have the basketball in the last shot.
Yeah, he wants him to go, Larry told him to go. Big thing now, watch out for the Scott
for the lead! My goodness gracious!
Holy mackerel!
Byron Scott with the 3-pointer.
Now this puts pressure on the Knicks.
Starts to Ewing, the spin move for the win. Yes, with 1.8 left.
Michael, who's wearing his mostly white shoes with black trim, that goes against league rules because the rest of his teammates have on all black shoes. And he wore number 23, and the Bulls did not report simply because Michael didn't tell anybody he was going to wear 23. The jersey changed for the league. That's also fun.
Play. Remember, Bob, we talked early in the first half.
What he brings. Jordan, hard to the hoop.
The reverse from Michael. They're on their feet. 33 points for Jordan. His first basket of this quarter.
Jordan goes away from the double team. You got to force him back to the double team. But look at the spectacular finish. One by 3 people. Here comes the double team. It doesn't mean anything. Shaq is too slow getting there. And then another poster by Michael Jordan. New shoes, new number again.
New poster.
And new face on the poster.
The problem with the shoes, he has not been wearing the right shoes, but today he will sport a brand new pair of shoes. They are black patent leather. They are very stylish. The only one thing is they are a little bit out of style because on the back of them, they have number 45. So if he's not wearing his old shoes, I guess there's nothing else that I could do but take his old shoes home. Marv?
Yes. About sports.
Game 7, to me, the home team has the pressure.
20.4 seconds, and the Rockets can use it all.
Houston has it in play. Here we go. Kenny Smith brings it up. Oh, they jumped inside the timeline.
I saw the double team coming. Get it to Robert.
And now he gets it across to Ori.
cornered. And I passed the ball, and the ball thought.
Morey, cross court pass in the left corner to Ellie. Ellie lines up a three. Oh my! Shot by Ellie.
I don't believe it.
As soon as I hit this shot, I just looked at this.
And look at him talk to the Phoenix bench.
Good night.
Knocked off the Phoenix Suns coming from behind the second straight year.
Ball is here. We're going to get him the ball and let him make the decision.
It took a matter of seconds.
Inbounds to Yuri. Down a three.
The second Dan laid open, you could see it. He could have driven a steamship down that lane.
And the Knicks fans are all thinking, yeah, we got.
I was near the top of the key watching the play happen.
And I'm sitting in the corner wide open. And I'm like, beast.
He's not throwing it to somebody else. It's his job to score there.
And rightfully so. As the big fella went into the paint area.
I remember thinking.
Laid the ball up.
I'm thinking.
All of it going up. I see the ball hit Budu.
He misses?
Teammates and my mom every day. What I need to do more, but she was mad in the Lakers series I didn't drive to the hole more often. And, so she says I need a hook shot too, but I don't know. But, she's when I first started playing basketball in high school, she didn't have any clue. She would come and she'd be yelling. She'd yell at the refs, yell at everybody, and I was so embarrassed all the time. But now she has a great understanding of the game, and she's fantastic, and she's, you know, my biggest supporter and everything. So I try to listen when she has something to say.
We'll throw in. It's got to be a catch and shoot. Here it is. Smith with the catch and the shot. Second effort by the big fella.
Gil O'Neal getting position, avoiding the double team. It will count. The call. 24-16. Three-pointer for Brian Shaw.
And assists all the way for Anthony Bowie. And six.
The kind of shots that we've seen. Antonio Davis got stripped. Two on one. Hardaway for O'Neal. See the smile on the face of the kid on air. Not bad. Third year of the NBA, and he is headed to the NBA Finals. Second, remaining, and a time.
good defense, Nick Anderson.
Elijah Wan. Rockets with a 5-0. Easily, Elijah Wan.
This is an opportunity for the Magic to get something up.
There was a good looking shot.
He wants the ball in his hands every time down the floor.
Elijah Wan has tied the game at 65.
Charles Jones out of the way.
Defense.
Elijah Wan with a jump hook. By Jones. Elijah Wan to the fireway. 26 for Akeem. Rockets lead by 10. Final seconds. Anderson. The Houston Rockets have won their second consecutive NBA championship. They have swept the Orlando Magic.